Welcome to another video of 2 kilobyte of fun. Last week they started broadcasting full HD television in this area of the Netherlands. Today I'm going to install a new video server. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use a Raspberry Pi with a DVB-T add-on so that it can grab the signal from the air. It should be comparable in quality to cable or fiber television services that cost a lot of money. And the idea behind this is that the service is totally free. So I'm going to use a couple of components. It will cost around 50 euros and it will allow me to grab the signal from the air, inject it to the whole network in our house, and we will be able to view the Dutch free-to-air television channels in every room in this house. And on top of that, it will also add PVR functionality. That means that you can set up timers to record shows, and it will allow you to play them back on every device in the household. So that's very nice. And for 50 euro in parts, it's an amazing deal, I think. I will show you how to do it. We got a package from Germany, because Germany is a little bit further into using DVB-T, because they have more remote areas without cable and internet connections. And I'm going to show you what I bought and how to set things up. What is in the box? This is a SD card, 64 gigabytes. It should allow the installation of the Debian software, but it's also capable of storing roughly 50 hours of TV. This is a USB adapter with ample power for powering both the Raspberry Pi and the antenna. This is the Raspberry Pi TV head. Let's see what's inside. Some mounting tools. And this is the actual board. It's very tiny. It's a small little board, has a Sony chip, and this should be capable of decoding the new DVB-T2 signal. And then we have the Raspberry Pi 3B Plus, the latest model. And that one looks like this. So this is basically what we need to set up our TV system. And of course, we have the big box. I will open that later. It has the outdoor antenna. And first I'm going to check if the indoor antenna will be sufficient. But if it's not, I'm going to open it and add that one as well. Step one now is to set up the Raspberry Pi and mount the TV head on top of it. Okay, this is a close-up of both boards. So we see the most recent model of the Raspberry Pi, the 3B Plus. And we see the add-on board also made by the Raspberry Pi Foundation. And it's for decoding the free-to-air signals for television. What they do is they have a connector that plugs in on the bottom. It feels like it connects, not very sturdy, but I think it's okay. Some tiny bits. So we have little screws, small plastic feet. It's like this. I'm going to mount these. Now the feet are added to the bottom of the board. Now I'm going to put it on top. Okay, the board is in place. A little bit strange is that one of the feet is sitting on top of one of the chips. And this is what the bottom looks like. So here there are two screws and there's one screw extra. Okay, this is step one. The board is assembled. The next step will be that I'm going to fill this card with the software. There it is. Tiny SD card. I'm going to put it in this. Since I have a Mac computer and it has a full-size SD slot, I chose a pretty fast card with a reasonable high writing speed. The list of items I got. So you have an idea of the price and the exact types. Now I'm going to install Debian and TV Headend on the SD card. When you insert the SD card on a Macintosh, it will get a Unix disk drive name. And that name is over here. And this disk has the name disk6s1. And I need to copy this. This is the download from the Raspberry Pi website. I chose to download the light version of Debian. The download is roughly 300 megabytes. Now I have to put this image onto the SD card. And I'm going to use the terminal for it. Okay, this is the website with an instruction on how to install Debian on a SD card. This is the important command. I'm going to copy it into the terminal, but before I do that, I edit the command first in text editor. So I'm pasting it here. And now I drag the file from the Raspberry Pi image into the same window, and that delivers me the correct file location. So I'm copying it to the right position. You have to take care of the name of the path. If there is a space in it, it will not work, because then the terminal sees that as a different command. To prevent that, I choose a very easy folder name. Now I have to change the number. We saw it was number 6. So now I made the command, and I'm going to copy it into the terminal. I'm going to enter it. And the resource is busy. We have to fix that as well. And we do that by unmounting the disk. And I'm not going to eject it, because then it totally loses it. I'm going to disk utility. Here is the image, and I have to choose unmount. So it's still seeing the card, but it's unmounted. And now I can enter the command. Okay, this was pretty fast. It took 38 seconds. So that means that the writing speed to this card is, yeah, it's quite okay. The Raspberry Pi has booted up. Now I can get information, all the packages that are available. So it's connecting to the internet now. And the second command you have to do is sudo apt-get install get install TV Headend. Do we want to install all this? Yes. This will take about 2 minutes. Then I get a request to give an administrator username. And of course that goes with a password. Strange enough, the password is only entered once. And now the installation continues for another minute or so. Okay, now it's setting up stuff. Now we almost come to the end of the installation. Okay, that was it. So now we have the system installed. I'm going to access the Raspberry Pi through a browser. To do so, I need the IP address of this machine. And this is the information window. Okay, this is the one I need. So this is my local address, 2.45. So I have to remember that number. And now I'm going back to my Mac. Okay, so you can't use HTTPS. Okay, and this is the configuration menu. I'm going to put it in Dutch. Program language, I also want it in Dutch. And second preference is English. And third, we'll see some German television as well. Okay. save and next. For now, I only want local access. 192.168.2. Okay. The tuner. Here, DVB-T network. I'm going to check if the Netherlands are here. Netherlands. Okay. Okay, now it's scanning for channels. And here you can see it has found some Sony input. So that must be the chip on the TV head. Here you can see it's trying all kind of frequencies. It found 35 muxes. And what I'm going to do is that I'm going to install a client for the TV headend software that runs on the Raspberry Pi. This is the home screen of Kodi. There can be more items on the left. I removed a couple. I'm going to TV and then you see add-on explorer. I click this, I go a little bit down, and here you see the TV headend client. I click it, I choose install. Okay, it is installed. Now you see this window, and here I can configure it. The only thing I have to do is enter the right IP number, 192.168.2.45 in this case. The number, of course, will depend on your settings in the LAN router settings. Okay, it demands a restart. That means a restart of Kodi, so I'm going to quit it. There it's again. Okay, now things have changed. What you can see here is some menu options. Here you can choose the channels. There are four channels right now. I have an electronic program guide. Here you see all the programs. And as you can see, there are two programs that have a little mark underneath. And that means, well, it's not a mark, it's a little clock. It means that these programs have been set up for recording. And it's very easy. So for example, if I want to record this one as well, I right click it and I choose record. Okay, here you can see all the finished recordings. So all these programs are already on the SD card. Oh, and here you can see the timers. These programs are due for recording. Here you can see the last played channels. And if you move down, you see the most recent recordings. You can do a similar thing with the radio, and when you install the TV client, the radio client comes with that automatically. So these are the public radio channels. The quality is comparable to the DAB digital broadcasting. Okay, let's have a look at the image quality. As you can see, the detail is pretty good. The broadcast is free from digital rights management, so that means that you can record the stream in its original format. Even the the ancient teletext is recorded along. This was also in the box. I'm not going to use it. It's an external antenna for people that have a poor signal. It turned out that the signal here is very strong. And when I looked on the map where the antennas are, I found out it's only 4 kilometers away. So that probably makes things work with an indoor antenna, and that's this one. It's a very small antenna. I had it because I used DVB-T before, and what I did was I just reused the antenna. It fits perfectly on the Raspberry Pi TV head. I hope you enjoyed this little video on making a DVB-T2 server in your house. It allows you to freely view public TV channels if your country has DVB-T signal available. I found the quality to be very nice with the new signal. The ease of use with Kodi is extremely well done. It's very easy to set up timers, to make recordings, to play them back. You can do it everywhere in your local area network. It works fantastically. The sound is nice in sync in Kodi. I have to say that the Mini that is running this TV screen is quite capable of decoding the very advanced video signal. It's totally flawless. I didn't see any problems with it. And that's quite amazing because it only has a 2.26 gigahertz Core 2 Duo processor from 2009. The video card is also very simple. It's a GeForce 9400M. It has some hardware decoding, but yeah, you can see it it manages really well. So in our household right now, we only have a 4G telephone connection for accessing the internet, because that one is in the Netherlands very much on par with speeds from cable and fiber. And for the television, we use this setup right now. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and see you again soon. This is what is left of our cable connections. Poor little boxes.